Allah Azza wa Jal gives us a story. My brothers in Islam, who is Barsisa? Barsisa is someone who worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was from among Bani Israel. He worshipped Allah for 70 years. 70 years. And he did not disobey Allah even a blink of an eye. He made a house, a worship house for himself above the mountain. He isolated everyone. He believed that he can reach Allah alone. He went and he began to worship Allah by himself. 10 days fasting, he comes out for a break. 10 days he prays in his house, then he comes out, takes some fresh air and goes back in like this. For Iblis wanted to, and he wanted to deceive him. So Iblis didn't know how to deceive him. So he made a sitting, a gathering, a meeting with the shayateen, marada to shayateen, the most evil and wretched of shayateen. And he said to them, what do you say? How are we going to deceive this person? One of the shayateen, whose name was Al-Abyad, he said, leave it upon me and I'll deceive him. So with shaytan, he dressed as a worshipper and he went to Barsisa and he constructed a worship house right next to Barsisa and he began to worship. Sure, for shaytan, he did not construct a nightclub next to Barsisa. So Barsisa would worship and he would come out. And every time he'd come out, he'd see a shaytan in sujood, crying, making dua. He's affected. Allahu Akbar. Who's this friend of Allah that he's worshipping? Time over time, months after months went by. Eventually, a shaytan came to Barsisa and he said to him, teach me from what Allah has taught you. For Barsisa said to him, Anta al-wali. You're the one that's supposed to teach me. Teach me what Allah has taught you. For he said to him, let me teach you something. And he taught him a word of lie, that if it was to be read on someone that is possessed, he'll be cured. Barsisa took this word, where shaytan went down to society and he began to possess the people. Allah send him to Sheikh Barsisa. He's got the name, he's got the cure, he's got the solution. They take him to Barsisa. Barsisa would read this word of lie, where shaytan would come out. One person after another, until shaytan realized that Barsisa is in his hand right now. So shaytan went to Iblis and he said to him, I have destroyed this man. Khalas. Iblis said, how? But he's still praying. He's still fasting. Until the shaytan, he went and he possessed the most beautiful woman in society. Well, where are we going to send this woman? Take her to Sheikh Barsisa. He's got the word. He's got the solution. As Sheikh Barsisa came down, he read. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. As shaytan, he said to him, Ya Barsisa, this woman is very bad and she's corrupt and sinful. This name is not going to work on her. Take her to your palace. Let her see from you al-ibadah. Let her worship with you. And then eventually when she makes a tawbah, you read the name, he'll come out. La a'uzu billah. How can I do this? Sheikh Barsisa, you don't fall in the fitna. Anyway, he agreed. Her parents agreed. They took her to his house and she remained there for a while. And from time to time, a shaytan would possess her and he would bring her into these modes of fits in where she would uncover herself. Barsisa would see that until time after time, he fell and he did and he committed a zina with her. For then a shaytan came and he said to him, Ya Barsisa, she's pregnant from a zina and the people are going to make a mockery and a shame out of you. And he said to him, go kill her. And then the people will say, Barsisa al-abid, go back into your worship and in your prayer and in your fasting, oh, khalas, neglect everyone, don't worry about them. So he did that, he killed her and he buried her. But shaytan said to Barsisa that if her family comes, say to them that, she was possessed with shaytan, took her, Allahu alam where she went. Shaytan went to her family. And he said to her family that Barsisa committed zina with her. He killed her and he buried her in such and such place. So they went and followed and they saw where she was. And they came down and they all wanted to kill Barsisa for what he did. So they grabbed him and they choked him and they took him to the king's palace. And the verdict was ruled down, handed down the death sentence on Barsisa. For now the entire village and community is around this man that worshipped Allah for 70 years. And they came. And they wanted to kill him. Shaytan appears in the form of a man before Barsisa. And he said to him, Ya Barsisa, no one can save you from this except me. Listen to me. He says to him, what is it? Give me the solution. People are going to kill me. He said to him, Usjudli Ya Barsisa. Make sujood for me. Make sujood for me. I'll save you from all of this. He said to him, how? You told me zina and I committed zina. You told me to kill and I killed. Now make sujood for you. So Sheikh Barsisa fell into sajda for Iblis and the people killed him and he died upon shirk wa kufr wal'ayadhu billah. Sheikh Barsisa, 70 years of worship. That's how his last day on earth was. And Allah Azza wa Jal said, both of them, Ash-Shaytan wa Barsisa, their punishment was أنهما في النار خالدين فيها وذلك جزاء الظالمين. You know what destroyed him? He thought he can reach Allah alone. He isolated himself from his community. He might have thought that the people are no good for him, that he worships better than the people. Like some people we have today. Yalla, everyone is a kafir. Everyone is misguided. Beware, my brothers, that you're not another barsisa that is living.